I'm here at the Bridgewater, New Jersey Electrify America charging station, topping off this 2020 Bolt EV. We're about to head out to the New Jersey Turnpike and do a range test, a highway range test. Going to be driving the car at a constant 70 miles an hour and be going up and down the New Jersey Turnpike. We go up and down in a loop so that we can negate any possible effects that it might have from elevation changes. It's not a perfect range test, but in doing that, it does make it a little bit more accurate. So we're going to head out here now, see how far this 2020 Bolt EV takes us. Now, the 2020 Bolt EV has a bigger battery than previous year's Bolts. This car has 66 kilowatt hours of usable capacity. The full size of the battery is somewhere around 75 kilowatt hours, but we get 66 kilowatt hours to use. Previous versions of the Bolt only had 60 kilowatt hours to use. So that car was EPA rated at 238 miles per charge. This car is EPA rated at 259 miles per charge. Now, we don't expect to go 259 miles of a constant 70 miles an hour. You very rarely match the EPA range rating when it's all highway driving, which is what we're gonna do. Personally, I'll be really happy if we get somewhere around 220 to 230 miles, but we'll see. We're gonna head out now, gonna check back in somewhere along the way with an update. All right, so we're halfway through. We've driven 104 miles at 50% state of charge. The Bolt has some great displays here. It even shows us how much kilowatt hours we've consumed, and it was exactly 33 kilowatt hours, which is half of the 66 we have usable. Some things of note. It's a little bit windier today than it is when I do some of my other range tests. We're showing a 12 to 13 mile an hour wind coming from the southwest. So when I'm driving down the turnpike, it's not an exact headwind, but it's definitely partially a headwind. And I noticed that when I'm doing my loops, when I'm driving south, my consumption is like 3.1 miles per kilowatt hour. But then when I turn around and head north, it goes up above 3.2 miles per kilowatt hour. So the wind is having an effect. How many miles? I really can't quantify that, but it's probably going to shave a few miles off the Bolt's range in this test. So it's right now 64 degrees. When we started, it was 59 degrees. Little cooler than what I really like to start. Ideally, I'd like to be somewhere between 65, 70 degrees for most of the trip, but it is what it is today. Shouldn't really affect it. I notice on the Bolt's display here, there's no battery conditioning at all, so that hasn't sapped any of the energy. The Bolt didn't realize it didn't need to do it. I am using a little air conditioning because it is warm, even though it's only 64 out. It's a bright sunny day, so the sun's baking on the cabin and it's a little warm. So we have the air conditioning on, but I also can see on the Bolt's driving display that it's only climate settings is only used 1% of our energy. 99% of the energy we've used so far has been going for driving. So that's good that we're not really sapping too much energy for heating or air conditioning and hurting the range. So 50% in, 104 miles. Bolt's range estimator says 104 miles to go. It's pretty much dead on. It seemed accurate so far. It's been counting down exactly how far we've been going. The Bolt's range estimator seems to be dead accurate. Let's see what happens when we finish up. So we're done. How good did we do? Better than I thought. We actually finished up with 218 miles driven, and we only used 64 of the 66 kilowatt hours in the battery pack. Now, I don't know the exact state of charge because when the Bolt gets under 15 miles remaining, for some reason, Chevy removes your remaining miles of estimated range and just puts low in. And then when you get really low, the low just starts blinking. Now, what I can say is when I did plug it into an Electrify America, no, actually EVgo charging station we were closer to, when I plugged it into the charging station, the station said that I was at 1% state of charge, which makes sense. It was probably right about 1%. I would have liked to run it to zero, but if I would have passed this charging station and went to the next exit to turn around, we wouldn't have made it back. So we're going to have to settle on 1% using 64 of the 66 kilowatt hours usable. Now, you can extrapolate how much further it would have went, because during this whole trip, we averaged 3.4 miles per kilowatt hour. The second half of the trip was much more efficient than the first half. First half, we averaged 3.1, 3.2 miles per kilowatt hour. And the overall trip, we averaged 3.4. So we must have averaged close to 3.5 or 3.6 in the second half. We had the wind to our back for a good portion of that. And also for towards the end, the wind died out to nothing, which at 70 miles an hour really helps if you don't have any type of extra wind holding the car back. So the 2020 Chevy Bolt EV, full charge down to 1%. We went 218 miles. If you want to add that extra 2 kilowatt hours that I didn't use, you got to figure it's going to have about another 5 or 6. 223, 224 miles at a constant 70 miles an hour. That's what the 2020 Chevy Bolt should do.